second super over in 10 games. Couldn't have asked for a better start to the Indian Premier League after the prolonged delay, isn't it? We have had yet another exciting game. Let's come down to the point. Give me your hit of the day.
I was very happy to watch Ishan Kishan bat. To tell you very honestly, I was very surprised that Mumbai Indians didn't start with Ishan Kishan, because he single-handedly won games for them in the past. I remember that game against KKR, which he single-handedly won. I was very happy to see him bat. Very unfortunate, he missed out on the 100, but what insane batting. I mean, he has all the shots in the book. And of course, he's been around in the IPL for so long. I remember him smashing Michelle Johnson also back in 2017 when he was playing for Gujarat. So it's been quite a while for Ishan, and I think the way he dominated those five overs which went for 90 runs along with Pollard, it was brilliant, brilliant to watch. So yeah, I'll go with Ishan Kishan. What about you?
My hit is, it's again a run fest, but I have picked Washington Sundar, the off spinner, who eventually turned out to be crucial for RCB, right? Had he not got Rohit in early, and had he let Mumbai Indians get off to a quick fast start, perhaps we wouldn't have even seen the super over, right?
Right, right.
And just imagine, in a match where both the teams have scored 201 runs each, you bowl in the power play, which has been your specialty, and you concede 12 runs in 4 overs and pick the best man in the opposition. You can't ask for a better outing. Add to that the fact that in the first couple of games, you have bowled only 3 overs combined.
Yes.
Okay, so I'm sure Washington couldn't have asked for a better outing today.
13 dot balls, if I'm not wrong, right?
Yeah, exactly. Keep saying that life is not about hits. Let's come to misses. Give me yours for that.
It's very unfair to call it a miss, because it's just one game. It can always come around better. But then the person I have picked is somebody who's had a good IPL so far. Yuzvendra Chahal, because he's picked up a few wickets in the first few games. I think he was on 5 wickets in his third game. So yeah, but then that over that he bowled to Pauly, I mean, that totally changed the course of the game. So I was very disappointed with the fact that he got totally bogged down by the pressure, and also there was the due factor. The bowlers were having a tough time to give the ball. I saw him trying to get the ball dry with the mud and all that, and then Nafeep Saini also towards the end, he's constantly trying to dry the ball. So that was a challenge. But then every team had its own challenges, and both the teams played in the similar ground, and I was very disappointed with the way that over was bowled. But I am sure he'll come around in the next game. What about you?
My miss is the Mumbai Indians team management. Whosoever decided that Ishan Kishan would not face in the super over made a blunder. We saw it in the first super over of the tournament, wherein Mayank Agarwal didn't walk out to bat for Kings 11. Okay, agreed, the conditions are extremely difficult. AB de Villiers couldn't even attend the presentation ceremony after the match. But here is a man who is in form, okay, who has got out just one ball before the end of the match, who has got you back into the game and almost seen you through. Rohit Sharma after the game did hint at Ishan raising his hand,
not being comfortable, he said,
he was cleaned out. Yeah, but my simple point is, what is the team management there for? If someone is hitting it well, you ask him to do that for 6 more balls. The likelihood of them getting a couple of boundaries was much more than Hardik, who hadn't batted for a real long time. It was much more. So eventually that turned out to be decisive when it comes to taking home 2 points.
But I wanted to ask you one thing. What would you say if the player says that he's not comfortable after playing that long innings? I mean, he batted for more than half of Mumbai Indians' innings. So what do you have to say if the player says that he's not comfortable batting and he's not sure that if he can get the team past the line?
Then he shouldn't be in the 11.
All right.
If he's not sure, he shouldn't be in the 11. And that is precisely the role of the management. That's what I'm saying.
Right,
it's the think tank that we refer to as. They should have pushed him.
Going on to the next game, Sunrisers versus Delhi Capitals. What are your picks for the game? Who are the matchups that you can think of for this game?
Yeah, I'm really keen to look at Rishabh Pant versus Bhuvneshwar Kumar. Okay, we saw AB de Villiers doing it for RCB in match 10. Okay, AB de Villiers has the best strike rate in IPL since 2018 when it comes to playing in over 16 to 20. The next best man after him is Rishabh Pant. Okay, people don't really give him his due when it comes to T20s, especially IPL. And Bhuvneshwar Kumar has been one of the best, if not the best, Indian pacer in death overs after Bumrah now in the last couple of years.
Right.
But if you look at the longer run, he is the best. So I am desperate to see how that contest pans out, assuming that Delhi Capitals get off to a flyer and we do end up seeing that contest. What's yours, Vidhan?
Right, I mean, before I say that, I mean, I also saw Bhuvneshwar bowl the other day. I mean, I don't know whether it's been a little bit of a stop-start journey for him in the recent times because of the injury. He's still wicketless in the tournament, which is also very surprising. So, I'll go on to my matchups. That is, I was very impressed with the way Prithvi Shaw handled the new ball the other day against Chennai Super Kings. So, yeah, I would like to see the contest between the Sunrisers Pacers versus Prithvi Shaw. Of course, Shikhar Dhawan is there to back him really well. So, it will be great to see that. Because he plays his strokes and he doesn't really fear of, you know, not playing that shot that he wants to play. So that fearless approach really works for Delhi Capitals upfront. I mean, someone of the order, if he can have that approach, and somebody who's so young as Prithvi Shaw, it's really beautiful to watch that. And we all have followed his journey from the Mumbai cricket days, the Maidan days, from then from under 19, 20 team. It's good to see somebody blossom in a very nice manner in good company too. So yeah, Prithvi Shaw versus the Pacers.